horse, people! Ouch. So, this horse either accidentally, I don't see any whiskers on the horse. See how the whiskers look like they were cut off? This is why this horse has this probably stuck in his face. But he's eating or trying to get grass, and this some sort of cactus or barb got caught in his lip. And so now this cowboy is going to try and help him, and he gets hit in the face for his efforts. So let's take a look at it because it's pretty short.
Eat this stuff. You know what's the best thing
to do?
You can get in there, just pull it out like a comb.
Oh. Okay, so let's kind of take a look at this little kick here.
There, just pull it out like a comb.
Remember, this is not a horse issue. This guy's trying to help this horse. I don't know if this halter's tied right. It almost looks like the halter's tied wrong, which really drives me nuts. And you've got this long thing here that's not tucked in that can slap and hit a horse. But anyway, I digress. And the fact that his whiskers were trimmed kind of irritated me. But let's see this frame by frame here on how quick this guy. He pulls. It hurts the horse. He rears up. The guy has no time to react. And the horse says, ow, that freaking hurt. And as he's coming down, I think he sticks his fin out. I'm not even sure this is a strike by the horse. I think this is just like, ouch, and he reared up. He didn't want to flip over. Putting the legs out kind of counterbalance the flipping over or rearing up. And it ends up hitting the guy in the face. I'm not even sure if you really... Oh, I guess he did hit him because the hoof's there. It happens pretty quick. Eh, the hoof's pretty close. He might have reared back and just fell back to avoid. It might have just clipped him. Maybe pushed on his chest there a little bit or his shoulder.
You know what's the best thing to do? You get in there, just pull it out like a comb.
You hear that person in the background? There's always people giving advice. Other people listen and they get hurt. Because the person giving the advice is in no jeopardy of getting hurt. He has no skin in the game. I always tell people, don't really listen to other people. Oh, just get on him. He'll be all right. Oh, yeah, he can be ridden. Yeah, hop on him. Oh, yeah, he's good. You can do that. Go ahead and do that. Yeah. Go ahead and pick up his back foot. He'll let you do it. He won't kick. They have no skin in the game. Don't listen to stupid stuff. Now, I don't think this guy's stupid. I probably would have done the same thing. I mean, I just don't know if I'd have done this a whole lot different. After seeing this, what I might have done different is pull his head this way so I'm standing by his shoulder. Therefore, when I pull it off, his natural instinct will be pull his head away from me. What this guy did, I think, looking at this and kind of evaluating it, is he let the horse turn his head to avoid the pain. He got focused and reached in. So now when the horse rears, he's naturally going to pull his head to the center and go straight up. Whereas if he'd have been by the shoulder, he would have pulled his head to the center and straight up, and the guy could have pushed off on the shoulder. So that's probably how I would have done this different. And I had thought about it, or after seeing this, I don't know how. I think I would have probably done it like this guy. Just let me get in here and help this horse. And not really think about it. So I'm not saying this guy's a bad dude. He tried to help the horse. I like the fact that he's exercising his second minute and he's carrying a gun while he's riding. And I carry a gun when I ride. And I think everyone should carry a gun all the time. But that's just me. Anyway, that's on my gun channel that I cover that. Good Luck America is my gun channel where I handle cops and use of force and people that carry guns and things like that. But anyway, this guy, he's trying to help the horse. Oh. So he kind of gets banged up here. Let's see. Where is this rope halter tied correctly? I can't even tell if it's even tied. It almost looks like. Oh. Yeah, it might be tied correctly. The only thing is this loose piece should be tucked under this throat latch so it's not flapping around. But. I don't know where they've got the, this is the lead rope, and it comes up here, and it goes over here. So I don't know where the hell they got the lead rope on this horse. Man, that's gotta freaking hurt that poor horse. Ouch. Man. Right on his lip. Poor little guy. Now, it almost looks like in this picture, there's another horse over here. So this picture was earlier, and then he went in to go get it. Because I was like, what happened to this horse? If this is a moving video, what happened to this horse? He disappeared. It must have been earlier. He must have been standing by this horse when they took the picture and noticed it.
Julie, you cannot eat this stuff. Your
specialty- so this is where the guy makes us mistake. He gets suckered in by this horse. He gets tunnel vision. The horse says, don't touch it, urch. And instead of controlling the horse's head and moving it to where it's advantageous to him, and he's standing by the shoulder over here and making the horse head turn to him, he got focused and tunnel vision, and he went straight in for what he was doing. Predator behavior. This is what gets a lot of people in trouble. We go directly into what we want to do, and we don't stop and think that this may cause a reaction. This may cause a horse. This is going to be painful. When this horse feels his pain, what's his probably normal or natural response? And I think most people can predict now for sure. The response is going to be the rear. Ow, that freaking hurts! So this horse was not attacking him. I don't think he was being aggressive. I just like, I got to get you off me. That freaking hurt. And I'm thinking the little thing is still there on him. It is. So he didn't even get it out, even though he got knocked down. Poor little horse. Must be a barb in there that's really holding it. So anyway, good intentions. Hey, you can still get hurt being nice. Tell women that all the time. Horse doesn't care if you love him. This horse doesn't care. He doesn't even realize this guy's trying to help him. He doesn't know that. He knows that something's on my lip is hurting me, and I don't want you by it because it hurts. And I don't want you to make it hurt more. This horse does not have a human thought like, if you grab me with these strippers, I'm going to hit you in the face with my, I'm going to rear up and hit you with my paw. Now, there'll be people that will be describing this. Oh man, this horse is mean. He's dangerous. He should be put down. Horse should never rear. Horses will always rear if you do something stupid. This guy caused pain and caused a horse to rear. This is not a horse problem. This is this guy's problem. Even though he was trying to help, even though he had good intentions, still the horse, it's not the horse's fault. All right, we'll end that there. One last time. See this guy get knocked down. All right, this little horse, he's a good little horse. He's not mean. He was just reactive to pain. All right, we'll end that there. Buddy, miss to your good boys.